So if there is calls in arrears, so what we have to do, we have to show journal entry for receipt of arrears from the concerned shareholder. The following is the concerned entry. So first journal entry would be bank account data to calls in arrears account. So collect the amount from the shareholders. So credit calls in arrears account. If the concerned shareholders does not pay the arrears, okay, then its shares can be forfeited and also it can be reissued, wherein for this we have already discussed the journal entries earlier. So same journal entry should be passed. So this is step number one. The step number one is convert the partly paid preference shares into fully paid preference shares, either by call making a call on shares or by calls in arrears. What is step number two? Step number two will be, so pass entry for showing the preference share capital due. So we have to show the preference share capital amount due. How you are going to show this amount due, which we have already discussed while discussing the amalgamation and absorption chapter. The following are the entries to be passed in this regard. So if the preference shares are being redeemed at par, so what is the journal entry? Preference share capital account data to preference shareholders account. Okay, so this journal entry I think you remember, students. And if the preference shares are being redeemed at premium, what is the journal entry? Preference share capital account data, premium on redemption of preference shares account data to preference shareholders account. So here, why did we debit the redemption of premium on redemption of preference shares account? Because when you are redeeming at premium, it is a loss. Next, step number three, we have to pass entry for fresh issue of shares. So if the preference shares are redeemed out of fresh issue of shares, then the following entry for making a fresh issue of shares must be passed. What is the first journal entry? If the fresh issue of share is made at par, so the journal entry would be bank account data to share capital account. So debit what comes in, credit what goes out. You are collecting the cash and we are issuing shares. Second journal entry is, if the fresh issue is made at premium, then what is the journal entry? Bank account data to share capital account to securities premium account. So again we are collecting the amount, debit what comes in, what is going out? Shares are going out. And why we have to credit securities premium account? Because when you are issuing shares at premium, it is a profit. So the rule says, nominal rule says, debit all expenses and losses and credit all incomes and gains. The third journal entry will be, if fresh issue is made at discount. So journal entry will be bank account data, discount on issue of shares account data to share capital account. So when the shares are issued at discount, so again cash is coming in and shares is going out. So debit bank account and credit share capital account. And why do you debit discount on issue of shares account? Because issue of shares at discount is a loss to the company. So it has to be debited. Now we'll move on to step number 4. Ensure if there are sufficient funds to make the redemption. So we have to make sure that there is sufficient amount available in order to make the redemption of preference shares. If the company does not have sufficient cash balance or bank balance in order to redeem the preference share capital, it can dispose some of its marketable securities or current assets. So the following are the journal entries with this regard. So suppose if the company does not have sufficient amount of cash balance, students, then the company is going to sell some of their marketable securities or current assets. So what are the journal entries? If the asset is sold at book value, so journal entry will be bank account data to concerned asset account. So when you are selling any asset at book value, what is coming in? Cash. And what is going out? Asset. So you have to debit bank account and credit asset account. If the asset is sold at higher than the book value, then what is the journal entry? Bank account data, concerned asset account data to profit and loss account. So debit what comes in? Bank account. Credit what goes out? Asset account. And here also we are crediting profit and loss account. Why? Because you are selling the asset at more than the book value, which is a profit. And the nominal rule says debit all expenses and losses and credit all incomes and gains. The third journal entry would be if the asset is sold at lower than the book value, which means that you are selling at loss. Then what is the journal entry, students? Bank account data, profit and loss account data to concerned asset account, which means that bank debit what comes in? Bank account, that is cash. Then credit what goes out? Asset account should be credited. And debit all expenses and losses. So you have debited that expenses to profit and loss account. The next step is step number 5. So show the entry for creation of capital redemption reserve account out of divisible profits. I told you later on I am going to discuss about divisible profits. Now I got a chance to discuss what are these divisible profits. If the redemption of preference shares are made out of divisible profits, students, entry for transferring the amount from divisible profits to capital redemption reserve account should be made. So what is the journal entry? Concerned divisible profit account data to capital redemption reserve account. So this is the journal entry that we have to pass if you are redeeming the preference shares out of the divisible profit. So first you have to transfer the amount of divisible profit that you are utilizing to capital redemption reserve account. So what are those divisible profits include? It includes credit balance of profit and loss, appropriation account, reserve fund or general reserve, dividend equalization fund, sinking fund for redemption of debentures or debenture redemption fund account, insurance fund, workman's compensation fund, workman's accident fund, investment fluctuation reserve, taxation reserve or any other revenue reserve. So while working out the problems, first go through all these type of divisible profits, students. So following are, however, not divisible profits, and hence it must be, we must not be used for creating what? Capital redemption reserve. That is securities premium, profit prior to incorporation, development rebate reserve, capital reserve, balance of forfeited shares account. So all these are the items which do not form a part of divisible profits. One more note you have to remember, usually transfer to capital redemption reserve account will be made out of credit balance of profit and loss account. If the amount is insufficient, then other divisible profits must be used for transfer to capital redemption reserve. So on the basis of information available, the transfer can be sequenced. What does this note denote is that, students, first you have to make use of the credit balance that is available in profit and loss account for the purpose of redemption of preference shares. Suppose if the amount is not sufficient, then you have to make use of the divisible profits which I discussed earlier. Step number 6. Provide for premium on redemption of preference shares. So if we are redeeming the preference shares at premium, then how you are going to account for? If the preference shares are redeemed at premium, it being a loss, as I told you, when you are redeeming preference shares, it is a loss to the company. Why? Because you are redeeming more than the face value. It must be provided for out of securities premium and out of divisible profits. This point is very important, students. When you are redeeming the preference shares at premium, what are the amount that you can make use of? You can make use of securities premium and also divisible profits. If the securities premium is insufficient, then the following is the entry in connection with it. So what is the journal entry? Securities premium account data, divisible profit account data to premium on redemption of preference shares account. If the amount is amount available in securities premium is sufficient, then you don't have compound journal entry. The entry will be securities premium account data to premium on redemption of preference shares account. But students, suppose if the amount in securities premium is not sufficient, then you can make use of the divisible profits also. So then the journal entry will be securities premium account data, divisible profits account data to premium on redemption of preference shares account. The next step you have is step number 7. Show the entry for payment to preference shareholders. After all provisions are made, the preference shareholders must be paid with the amount shown as due to them. So the following is the entry to be passed for showing the payment. So I think you remember, students, when we were showing the amount due to the preference shareholders, then we had debited whose account? That is, preference shareholders account was credited and preference share capital account was debited. When you are making the payment, listen, the general entry would be preference shareholders account debit to bank account. So debit the receiver. Who is the receiver here? Preference shareholders, and credit what goes out? What is going out here? Cash. Note, if any preference shareholders is not traceable, that is, if you are not in a position to pay the amount to the preference shareholders, then the amount due to him remains as balance in preference shareholders account and would appear under current liabilities and provisions every year in the balance sheet. Suppose if there are 100 preference shareholders, students, and if you are in a position to make the payment to 90 students, then the remaining 10 students are untraced, then you have to show that the amount is due, like outstanding, okay, due under the head current liabilities and provisions in the balance sheet. Why? Because still we have not yet paid and the amount is due to the preference shareholders. And the step number 8 is show the journal entry for issue of bonus shares out of capital redemption reserve. So if the capital redemption reserve is used for issuing bonus shares to the existing members, then the following entry must be passed. For bonus issue, the general entry would be capital redemption reserve account data to bonus to equity shareholders account. Then for the next general entry will be for transfer of bonus shares, the bonus to equity shareholders account data to equity share capital account. So there are two general entries, students. First general entry is for issue of bonus. So what is the general entry? Capital redemption reserve account data to bonus to equity shareholders account. Second general entry is for transfer of bonus shares. The general entry would be bonus to equity shareholders account data to equity share capital account. So students, with this we will complete the theory part of the redemption of preference share capital chapter, students. In my next video, I will be working out the problems, and after working out the problems, along with the sending of link, I am going to send you the photocopy of the problems and also the solution. Thank you.